Dear friends in Christ, on this most holy night in which our Lord Jesus passed over from death to life, the Church invites her members dispersed throughout the world to gather in vigil and prayer. For this is the Passover of the Lord, in which by hearing his word and celebrating his sacraments, we share in his victory over death. Let us pray. O God, through your Son, you have bestowed upon your people the brightness of your light. Sanctify this new fire, and grant that in this Paschal feast we may so burn with heavenly desires that with pure minds we may attain to the festival of everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Be thou blessed in whose honor thou shalt be burnt.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice now, heavenly hosts and choirs of angels, and let your trumpet shout salvation, for the victory of our mighty King. Rejoice and sing now, all the round earth, bright with our glorious splendor. For our darkness has been vanquished by our eternal King. Rejoice and be glad now, Mother Church, and let your holy court in radiant light resound with the praises of your people. All you who stand near this marvelous and holy flame, pray with me to God the Almighty for the grace to sing the worthy praise of this great light. Through Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with him in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and good, always and everywhere, with our whole heart and mind and voice to praise you, the invisible, almighty, and eternal God, and your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb, who at the feast of the Passover paid for us the debt of Adam's sin, and by his blood delivered your faithful people. This is the night when you brought our fathers, the children of Israel, out of bondage in Egypt, and led them through the Red Sea on dry land. This is the night when all who believe in Christ are delivered from the gloom of sin and are restored to grace and holiness of life. This is the night when Christ broke the bonds of death and hell and rose victorious from the grave. How wonderful and beyond our knowing, O God, is your mercy and loving kindness to us, that to redeem a slave you gave a son. How holy is this night, when wickedness is put to flight and sin is washed away. It restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to those who mourn. It casts out pride and hatred, and brings peace and concord. How blessed is this night, when earth and heaven are joined, and man is reconciled with God. Holy Father, accept our evening sacrifice, the offering of this candle in your honor. May it shine continually to drive away all darkness. May Christ, the morning star who knows no setting, find it ever burning. He who gives his light to all creation, and who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Let us hear the record of God's saving deeds in history, how he saved his people in ages past, and let us pray that our God will bring each of us to the fullness of redemption.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that the light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome, and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years, and let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth. And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day and the lesser light to rule the night, and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky. So God created the great sea monsters and every living creature that moves of every kind with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful and multiply, and fill the waters in the seas, and let birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things and wild animals of the earth of every kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them. And God said to them, be fruitful, and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over every living thing that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit. You shall have them for food. And to every beast of the earth, and to every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done, and he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done. So God blessed the seventh day and hallowed it, because on it God rested from all the work that he had done in creation. These are the generations of the heavens and the earth when they were created.
Thank you. Let us pray. O God, who wonderfully created, and yet more wonderfully restore the dignity of human nature, grant that we may share the divine life of him who humbled himself to share our humanity, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
As Pharaoh drew near, the Israelites looked back, and there were the Egyptians advancing on them. In great fear, the Israelites cried out to the Lord. They said to Moses, "Was it because there were no graves in Egypt that you have taken us away to die in the wilderness? What have you done to us, bringing us out of Egypt? Is this not the very thing we told you in Egypt? Let us alone, and let us serve the Egyptians, for it would have been better for us to serve the Egyptians than to die in the wilderness." But Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid, stand firm, and see the deliverance that the Lord will accomplish for you today. For the Egyptians whom you see today, you shall never see again. The Lord will fight for you, and you have only to keep still." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. But you lift up your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the Israelites may go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh, his chariots and his chariot drivers." The angel of God, who was going before the Israelite army, moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and it lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night, and turned the sea into dry land, and the waters were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry ground, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord, in the pillar of fire and cloud, looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged their chariot wheels so that they turned with difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the sea so that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depth, As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers. The entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea, not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and in his servant Moses. Then the prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women went out after her with tambourines and with dancing. And Miriam sang to them, "Sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea."
I receive you, Lord.
Let us pray. O God, whose wonderful deeds of old shine forth even to our own day, you once delivered by the power of your mighty arm your chosen people from slavery under Pharaoh to be a sign for us of the salvation of all nations by the water of baptism. Grant that all the peoples of the earth may be numbered among the offspring of Abraham and rejoice in the inheritance of Israel. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Does not wisdom call, and does not understanding raise her voice? On the heights beside the way, at the crossroads, she takes her stand. Beside the gates in front of the town, at the entrance of the portals, she cries out, "To you, O people, I call, and my cry is to all that live. O simple ones, learn prudence. Acquire intelligence, you who lack it. Hear, for I will speak noble things, and from my lips will come what is right. From my mouth will utter truth. Wickedness is an abomination to my lips. All the words of my mouth are righteous. There is nothing twisted or crooked in them. My fruit is better than gold, even fine gold, and my yield than choice silver. I walk in the ways of righteousness along the paths of justice, endowing with wealth those who love me and filling their treasuries. To those without sense, she says, come, eat of my bread and drink of the wine I have mixed. Lay aside immaturity and live, and walk in the way of insight.
The sessions of the Lord, be joyous.
Let us pray. O God, you have created all things by the power of your word, and you renew the earth by your spirit. Give now the water of life to those who thirst for you, that they may bring forth abundant fruit in your glorious kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. He said to me, "Mortal, can these bones live?" I answered, "O Lord God, you know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones, and say to them, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you, and will cause flesh to come upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord." So I prophesied as I had been commanded, and as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to its bone. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, "Prophesy to the breath, prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live." I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived, and stood on their feet, a vast multitude.
Divine Lord, Lord,
Let us pray. O God of unchangeable power and eternal life, look favorably on your whole church, that wonderful and sacred mystery. By the effectual working of your providence, carry out in tranquility the plan of salvation. Let the whole world see and know that things which were cast down are being raised up, and things which had grown old are being made new, and that all things are being brought to their perfection by him through whom all things were made, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Out of the darkness of this most holy night burns a light. The light which illumines our hope, our faith, our very lives. You and I sit in darkness, and on this day we have been next to the empty tomb as we await the dawn of a new day, as you and I hope for the new life of resurrection. And all the while we are surrounded by the presence of the one true light that burns eternal. From God's mighty act of creation to the Israelites' liberation from the bondage of Egypt, to the new life breathed into a valley of dust and death, we, God's people, are reminded of our Lord's never-failing presence in our world and in our lives. The prophet Ezekiel is called to go down into the valley where life has been swallowed up by the desolate, dry ground of the Israelites' hopeless despair. To the human eye, all looks forsaken. For you see, God's people have endured great hardship while in exile and have lost much of who they are. And in the midst of it all, they have turned away from God. Yet in God's divine providence, all is not forsaken. For into that fear and hopelessness, something miraculous begins to happen. First, the prophet is asked, "Mortal, can these bones live?" Ezekiel knows that only God can answer such a question. Such knowledge is beyond a mere mortal. Only God proclaims a future. The creator of all life, with the prophet's help, sets about the work of transforming this valley into something new. God speaks through Ezekiel directly to those bones lying in the dust. And those bones hear something. Something very familiar. For you see, the word spoken to those bones is the same word that gives being and life in the first place. The same word that brought those bones out of bondage into the land of freedom. They know this word. They know this voice. And then, slowly, life returns, bit by bit, sinew by sinew, bone begins to rattle against bone. And then God, from the four winds of creation, breathes life into each one of them. God opens up the graves of his people and brings them forth, and into the darkness shines a new light. Tonight, this very night, all of us come from our own valleys seeking liberation from the dry and desolate parts of our lives that have perished and lost hope. We come to confess those wayward places within us that have rebelled against God. We come longing for the breath of life to renew and transform us. And into this night, we bring 10 of God's beloved children to the waters of baptism, where they will be buried with Christ in his death and reborn into the risen life. Into this night, we witness with those who have committed themselves to a time of study and preparation as they come before God to be renewed through the power of the Spirit in their commitment to Christ. Into this night, God shines the eternal light of his Son, Jesus Christ, that we might feel our bones begin to rattle with the breath of new life and the promise of God's salvation. We gather to remember the miraculous saving acts of God. Jesus the Christ breaks forth from the tomb and destroys death once and for all. On this night, may we always remember you and I never walk alone, even in the darkest of valleys, for we are accompanied by the one who died and rose for us, who continues to breathe new life into us and call us forth. The light of Christ shines forth into this most holy night that all might see and believe. Amen.
The candidates for holy baptism will now be presented. Thank you. Do you desire to be baptized?
I do.
I present the sacrament of baptism.
Do you desire to be baptized? Will you be responsible for seeing that the child you present is brought up in the Christian faith and life?
I will, with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help this child to grow into the full stature of Christ?
I will, with God's help.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior? Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love?
I do.
Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
The other candidates will now be presented.
I present these youth for confirmation.
I present these adults for confirmation.
I present these adults to be received into this communion. I present these adults who desire to reaffirm their baptismal vows.
Do you reaffirm your renunciation of evil?
I do.
Do you renew your commitment to Jesus Christ? Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support these persons in their life in Christ?
We will.
Let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenant. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God.
You believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God.
I believe in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life
continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers.
I will, God's help.
Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord?
I will, God's help.
Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ?
I will, God's help.
Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself?
I will, God's help.
Will you strive for justice and peace among all people and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, God's help.
Let us now pray for these persons who are to receive the sacrament of new birth and for those who have renewed their commitment to Christ.
Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection, and look for him to come again in reigns, now and forever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give you thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water, over it the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it you led the children of Israel out of their bondage in Egypt into the land of promise. In it your son Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death and resurrection from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. By it we share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into his fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that those who hear are cleansed from sin and born again, may continue forever in the risen life of Jesus Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever.
Amen.
Caitlin, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Cheyenne, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Julia, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Sam, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
William, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
A rough ride there. All right. Okay, here we go. Jacob, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That was pretty good. Gold star. Thank you. James, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alice, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Oh, good Alice. There we go. Josephine, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Alexander, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed upon these your servants the forgiveness of sin and have raised them to the new life of grace. Sustain them, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give them an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage to will and to persevere, a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Caitlin, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Sam, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Julia, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Alexander, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Josephine, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Alice, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
James, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Jacob, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
William, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Cheyenne, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever.
Amen.
Thank you. If the baptismal party will turn around and face the congregation, let us welcome the newly baptized. We receive you into the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. Let us now pray for these persons who have renewed their commitment to Christ. Almighty God, we thank you that by the death and resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, you have overcome sin and brought us to yourself, that by the sealing of your Holy Spirit, you have bound us to your service. Renew in these your servants the covenant you made with them at their baptism. Send them forth in the power of that Spirit to perform the service you set before them. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Congregation may be seated. Defend, O Lord, your servant Lillian with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom. Defend, O Lord, your servant Elijah with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he comes to your everlasting kingdom. Defend, O Lord, your servant Ryan with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he comes to your everlasting kingdom. Amen. Defend, O Lord, your servant Grace with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Shelby with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Alexandra with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom. Defend, O Lord, your servant Ellen with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Duncan with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Kenneth with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Lucy with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Jack with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant George with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Bruce with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant John with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Susanna with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Murray with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Allison, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Clayton with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Jan, may the Holy Spirit, who has begun a good work in you, direct and uphold you in the service of Christ and his kingdom.
Amen.
Larry, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Stephen, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Hillary, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Megan, we recognize you as a member of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Belinda, we recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Jeffrey, we recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Tiffany with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Stephanie with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Shara with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Robert with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Aaron with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Bradley with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Bree with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Jacob, we receive you. We recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Melanie, we recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
George, we recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Joshua with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Chris with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Lisa with your heavenly grace, that she may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until she comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Pamela, may the Holy Spirit, who has begun a good work in you, direct and uphold you in the service of Christ and his kingdom.
Amen.
Charles, we recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen.
Defend, O Lord, your servant Alan with your heavenly grace, that he may continue yours forever, and daily increase in your Holy Spirit more and more, until he comes to your everlasting kingdom.
Amen.
Marilyn, we recognize you as a member of the one Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, and we receive you into the fellowship of this communion. God the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you.
Amen. Amen.
Please stand. Almighty and ever-living God, let your fatherly hand ever be over these, your servants. Let your Holy Spirit ever be with them, and so lead them in the knowledge and obedience of your word, that they may serve you in this life and dwell with you in the life to come, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Thank you.
be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who made this most holy night to shine with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church that spirit of adoption which is given to us in baptism, that we, being renewed both in body and mind, may worship you in sincerity and truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Paul to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin, once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Christ.
When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices, so they might go and anoint him. And very early on the first day of the week, when the sun had risen, they went to the tomb. They had been saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone, which was very large, had already been rolled away. As they entered the tomb, they saw a young man dressed in a white robe, sitting on the right side, and they were alarmed. But he said to them, "Do not be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus of Nazareth, who was crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Look, there is the place they laid him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter that he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them. And they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you,
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Happy Easter. Offer to God a sacrifice of thanksgiving and make good your vows to the Most High. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Right to glorify you, Father, and to give you thanks, for you alone are God, living and true, dwelling in light inaccessible, from before time and forever. Fountain of life and source of all goodness, you made all things and filled them with your blessing. You created them to rejoice in the splendor of your radiance. Countless throngs of angels stand before you to serve you night and day. And beholding the glory of your presence, they offer you unceasing praise. Joining with them and giving voice to every creature under heaven, we acclaim you and glorify your name as we sing. We acclaim you, Holy Lord, glorious in power, your mighty works revealed, your wisdom and love. You formed us in your own image, giving the whole world into our care, so that in obedience to you, our Creator, we might rule and serve all your creatures. When our disobedience took us far from you, you did not abandon us to the power of death. In your mercy, you came to our help, so that in seeking you, we might find you. Again and again you called us into covenant with you, and through the prophets you taught us to hope for salvation. Father, you love the world so much that in the fullness of time you sent your only Son to be our Savior, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary. He lived as one of us, yet without sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, to the sorrowful, joy. To fulfill your purpose, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the grave, destroyed death, and made the whole creation new. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose for us, he sent the Holy Spirit, his own first gift for those who believe, to complete his work in the world, and to bring to fulfillment the sanctification of all. When the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, his heavenly Father, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. At supper with them he took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Father, we now celebrate this memorial of our redemption, recalling Christ's death and his descent among the dead, proclaiming his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, awaiting his coming in glory, and offering to you from the gifts you have given us, this bread and this cup, we praise you and we bless you. We praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God. Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be holy gifts for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that all who share this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and apostolic church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, and preserve it in peace. Remember Justin, Archbishop of Canterbury, Catherine, presiding bishop of the Episcopal Church, your humble servant, the Bishop of Tennessee, and all who minister in your church. Grant them all things necessary for their common life and bless them in their proclamation of the good news of Jesus Christ through the ministry of your Holy Spirit. In the Anglican cycle of prayer, pray for the peace of Jerusalem and for its bishop, the Right Reverend Suhail Dewani. Remember the men and women of the armed forces at home and abroad, especially Chris, Bradley, Chad, Sterling, and Toby, and all those on active duty from this community, and for all who suffer in war and civil strife. Remember Will, Roberta, Darlene, Lee, Duncan, Mary, Dot, Cleta, Jim, Renee, Gabriel, Mandy, and those we name before God or who are known to God in the silence of our hearts. Remember all who have died in the peace of Christ, especially Deanna Sharp, Jim Johnston, Ruth Regan, and Richard Tieford, and those whose faith is known to you alone. Bring them into the place of eternal joy and light. Remember all your people and those who seek your truth, especially the newly baptized, Caitlin, Alice, Samuel, Jacob, Lowell James, William, Julia, Josephine, and Cheyenne, and those confirmed, received, or who have renewed their baptismal vows this night. And grant that we may find our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. And now, as As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith, with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Body of Christ, bread of heaven. Body of Christ, bread of heaven. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God, who has redeemed us and made us his children through the resurrection of his Son, our Lord, bestow upon you the riches of his blessing.
Amen.
May God, who through the water of baptism has raised us from sin into newness of life, make you holy and worthy to be united with Christ forever.
Amen.
May God, who has brought us out of bondage to sin into true and lasting freedom in the Redeemer, bring you to your eternal inheritance. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Thank you.
Let us go forth into the world, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.